Hello everyone, Mr. Epic115 here. This is the second part to my tutorial videos for CSGO. And in this video, I'm going to be talking about basically just basic game stuff, the buy menu, and I'll be talking about each of the weapons in the game. Like, I'm going to cover all of them to some extent, basically. And in this match, I've just set up to where there's a lot of time, and I should have max ammo. Yeah, I have max ammo, and for some reason I don't have max money. I'm gonna have to fix that. Okay, sorry about that, people. I did have max money when I was in warm-up, but then it reset it for some reason. And I also have it set to where I can have more than just four nades, so I can show all the nades at the same time. So basically, what you see here is the CT spawn of Mirage, which is a very popular map. And you'll either be starting off with a USP like this, or a P2000, which I don't currently have equipped, so I can't show you, but you should know what that is. I mean, you'll quickly know what that is. And very basic stuff. E can bring up the buy menu, or it like does stuff, like it opens doors. You pick up a weapon with it, or you can just pick up a weapon by going over it. But G drops your weapon. F inspects the weapon, and WASD, that's move keys. That's pretty much standard though now. Tab brings up the scoreboard. Shift is to walk, which this is extremely important when you're trying to actually be stealthy. And control is to crouch, and this is also extremely useful because your shots are most accurate when you're crouching, although I don't really crouch too much anymore when I spray it. I do a lot of spraying with guns standing up. But anyway, left click is shoot, which I guess most people would expect that. And to switch through weapons, it's the number keys. Right now I only have the pistol and a knife, so it's just two and three right now, but it adds more as you get more weapons. And you can also use the scroll wheel for that. And most people say you should use the number keys, but I honestly use the scroll wheel more. It's just more accessible for me. It has screwed me up in the past though, but I'm pretty well set with it now to where I don't accidentally switch to something that I don't want to. And that's about it for the controls right now. Oh yeah, right click also. For this weapon, it can take off the suppressor, and also for the M4A1S, it can do that. And right click is also used for aiming in on some weapons. So that's it for basic key command stuff. So now we'll just get into the buy menu. To enter the buy menu, you press B or E. And you have pistols, heavy SMGs, rifles, gear, and grenades. We'll start off with gear. For CT side, you have the Kevlar vest, the helmet, a Zeus, and a defuse kit. Basically, at the beginning of every round, unless you're ecoing, which is trying to save money, and on pistol round, you can't buy full armor, but you'll want to buy a full armor and a defuse kit if you have enough money, which that's extremely important. And a Zeus, it's only $100 because of the CSGO birthday thing that's going on or whatever it is, but that's kind of just for trolling, honestly. I mean, it is good. It does instantly kill if you're like extremely close to them. But yeah, basically, to give a rundown on the Zeus, it's just if you're like 5 feet away from them and want something that can kill them instantly, that's what it's good for. Infinite ammo, OP. And then after that, I'll get to grenades later. You have pistols, which I already have a USP. And the USP versus the P2000, honestly, I think if you're first starting out, which if you're watching this video, you probably are, you'll probably want to use the P2000. It's just, like, it has a little bit more ammo. It's just better if you're trying to get more body shots and just trying to kill people kind of spraying. Like, this is a better gun if you're really aiming up shots and trying to pick off heads. And that's about it for the stock pistols. Then you have the dual Berettas, which honestly, not too many people use these, but they are okay, and I would highly suggest them for someone who's starting out, because they have a huge ammo capacity. And don't, I guess because infinite ammo is only showing the left one firing, but when you have it actually in game, they'll both, it'll fire like the left one, then the right one, back and forth, you know. But yeah, they're pretty good. They do decent damage. They're not very accurate, but like I said, if you're starting off and you're just running in a sight and just spraying at people, they're a good gun. Well, good guns, I should say. Then the next pistol is the P250. This is potentially the best all-around pistol for the price, like considering price. If you're kind of on a tight buy, but you still want to upgrade your pistol, this is definitely what you're going to want to do, because it's decently accurate. It does good damage, and it has a decent mag capacity, although they did nerf the ammo capacity. It used to carry a lot more, like double what it carries now, I think. But yeah, it's just a good pistol. If you're ecoing, it's a good pistol to buy it. And that's about it for the P250. Gotta get rid of that Zeus. It's annoying me. Then you have the 5.7, which I guess I should add that this is CT exclusive. Of course, the USP and P2000 are also CT exclusive. But I'd say a lot of people consider this the best pistol in the game. Although, I guess most people consider the Tech 9 the best pistol in the game. Not sure why that's there. It's not supposed to be there. It's just a texture glitch. Oh, the game just lagged too. But anyway, this is a great pistol. It has a large mag capacity, and it's good for picking, good for getting headshots, and it's also honestly good for spraying if you need to. Now, obviously, if you're going to be spraying a lot, then you're just going to want to use the dual Berettas. But yeah, this is a really great, honestly, it's a great standalone gun too, because you can use this if your team's buying up some SMGs or even on full buy and you don't have very much money. You can get armor in a 5.7 and still do decent. Then after that, you have the famed Deagle, Desert Eagle. And really, if you're a beginner, you're probably not going to want to use this, because you'll just be running in. And this gun has pretty much the worst spray accuracy in the entire game. Not really, but it's not very good at all. Although, I guess it's not extremely hard to get lucky with it, like just spraying down people and getting headshot, but if you're just going to be spraying with a weapon, you're not going to want to use this. This is a lot better for probably later on when you're just going to want to be aiming for the head and getting headshots. And it's also a ridiculously expensive pistol. Not like, I guess it's not ridiculously expensive, but it's kind of a waste of money sometimes, unless you're buying up as just a standalone pistol. Although, it's not bad if you're using a shotgun and you want to have a secondary that has range. It could work, but I wouldn't suggest it much. Now we'll move on. We'll do the heavy later. Not later, but in a minute. SMGs. The MP9 is a pretty good gun. I mean, it's good if you're wanting like a second round buy or even later on. Something that can do some damage and has a good rate of fire. I mean, that's just about it for the MP9. It's just a good SMG if you're tight on money. Then you have the MP9, which honestly, I think, for the price, because the P90 is expensive, this is the best SMG, especially if you're buying, for like, an anti-eco round. Well, no, I guess the PP Bison's pretty good for that, but this is a decent gun even on later rounds when they have rifles. It's comparable, because it's decent for headshots, and it's just a good spraying gun, too. It's just a really good SMG. Then you have the UMP, which, honestly, for the price and everything, this is also a good SMG. Which, there's really not a bad SMG on the game, but, I mean, consider the price and all that. This is a good gun. Has good accuracy, too. It's just a decent weapon. Sorry if I'm seeming, like, boring. P90, for beginners, I would highly suggest using this. Yes, people, I know, experienced people, if they see this video, they're going to be like, oh, no. Don't tell people to start using the P90. But if you're just a beginner who's trying to get to know game skills and just wanting a gun that you can run in and spray with, you're not going to be able to beat the P90. It's just a spray machine. And honestly, I use it sometimes if I can't buy a rifle, but it's just a great gun for spraying. It's expensive, though, as far as SMGs go. That's why the SMG I use the most is the MP7, because it's just, it's somewhat cost-effective, and it's good. And then you have the SMG that I would say, well, there's more lag. I would say most people use this as far as, like, a anti-eco round goes, you know, second, third round, stuff like that, because it's a beast against people without armor. It's great for spraying. I mean, if they're rushing in with pistols, sometimes you can just absolutely wreck them. And it's also okay, it's not, well, I guess it is okay for later rounds if you're beginning, I guess. You could use it on later rounds if you just want something that doesn't really have any kickback and has a huge clip and just a ton of spray. It would work, but it hardly does any damage against armored people, so that's why it's not very good for later rounds. But it could be, I guess. I keep second-guessing myself. We'll do the rifles last, because they're the most used. Now, we'll start off with the heavy, which, the Nova, I mean, if you're in a round where you're going to spend $1,200 for a gun, I would probably go with the UMP, but if you are playing a tied-up bomb site where you're close to people and you can play a good angle, I mean, I guess you could use it on B site here on Mirage. It's a decent gun, because it does a good amount of damage, and it actually has good range, too, but I just would probably get the UMP instead in most situations, or just get a 5.7 or something, and not spend as much. It's a good gun, though. And the auto shotty, I actually have a friend who mains this instead of rifles, but it's just a really good gun, too. It can be used in later rounds, too, if you like using shotguns a lot, because you can just wreck people with this. Absolutely wreck them. And it has a decent mag capacity, and it does decent damage, and it's semi-automatic, which is really the best part. I don't know why I keep going back to the spawn. I forgot I had the buy anywhere thing selected. Then you have the Mag 7, which, it's a good gun, but its range is crap, and it's just, if you know you're going to be really close to them, and you feel pretty confident that you can get them in one shot, if you want to spend $1,800, the Mag 7 is a decent gun. I don't really use it that much, though. But I used to use it quite a lot back when I liked shotguns a lot. And now getting on to the heavy machine guns, which if you see someone bringing one of these out, you're probably getting beaten really badly, or it's on the last round of the half and they're just spending their money. The M249, honestly, for the price, is a kind of terrible gun. Unless you're good with it, but has a decent rate of fire, but its kickback is terrible. But if, I mean, it does do a lot of damage, but if you're gonna spend that much money to get a heavy machine gun, you should just get the next one, which is the Negev, because it carries more ammo, it has a faster rate of fire, and it just completely decimates people. So if you're gonna spend that much money on a gun, just go the next step, spend the extra 500 and get the Negev, because you're probably just going to be messing around anyway. And also, if you're a beginner player, which you probably are if you're watching this, then if you have a ton of money, it's going to be a great gun to use, because you can just run in and spray people down with it, you know. Now moving on to the rifles, which is probably the most used category, I would say, once people have the economy. The FAMAS, if you don't have enough money for an M4, this is a pretty good gun for CT side. I mean, it does have a strange spray pattern, but it does decent damage, and I mean, it's just, if you can't afford an M4 and you still want to pretty much have a full buy for your team, you can get a FAMAS. It's more than good enough to get the job done. Then you have the good old M4, which I use the M4A4. There's also the M4A1S, and I would just encourage you to experiment with which one you like better, because the M4A4 is cheaper and it carries more ammo, so you can spray better with it. But it also has less accuracy than the M4A1S. But that's really about it. I used to use the M4A1S back in the day, but it also used to cost $300 less back in the day. So now it just seems kind of crappy to me that the M4A1S cost $100 more than the M4A4, even though overall it's kind of a worse gun. But if it was the same price, I'd probably not really be too biased between them. I just prefer this because it's pretty good for picking, going for headshots, picking off heads. I just said the same thing three times in three different ways. But it's also good if you're trying to spray down a large group of people. And the M4A1S does have good spray, it's just that it doesn't carry as much ammo, so you're going to end up spraying someone down, and then turning and wanting to shoot someone else, and you're not going to have any ammo. But I do prefer the M4A1S for picking from long range. Then you have the SG, which, if you really love using scoped weapons, and that's just like, you do the best with them, it's your favorite thing, it's all you want to use, then this is an okay gun to buy until you can afford an AWP. I buy it sometimes, because depending on what I'm watching, if I'm going to be watching A, I probably wouldn't get one on this map. But if I'm watching mid, I would probably pick one up just because it's cheap and you can get the range with it. But it also usually takes two shots to kill, so that's why it's so much cheaper than the AWP, is just because it does way less damage. But yeah, it's a okay gun for some things. Then you have the AUG, which I never use the AUG. I really can't stand it anymore. I used to use it a ton. But I would highly suggest it for beginners because it does have a scope and it's extremely accurate. So if you're coming from Call of Duty, which you might be, or if you're coming from anything, really, this is a decent gun to start with, because you can just use it like a Call of Duty gun. But as you get later on in the game, you're probably not going to want to use it, because it just... you can't be aiming in every corner you turn and every time you see someone, and you'll want to have a gun that is better for spraying and stuff like that. But it is a great gun for beginners. Then you have the AWP, which you're probably going to play with a lot of people that want to use the AWP, which I am an AWPer sometimes. I've kind of been AWPing a little more lately than I used to, but it's a great gun. I mean, simple as that. If you're good with it, it's a really good gun. If you're bad with it, then it's probably a terrible gun. But if your team needs an AWPer, which pretty much every team in general will need an AWPer, then if you have the money and you don't already have 3 AWPs on your team, because I know how sometimes those lower ranks can be getting like 5 AWPs because everyone wants to use an AWP, then you should pick one up. I mean, it's just a great gun. Good damage. Obviously good range. And it just gets the job done. And last but certainly not least is what would be considered the most scrubbiest gun in the game. The auto sniper, or the SCAR 20 as it's technically called in the game. And yeah, it's literally just an AWP, except it doesn't shoot a single shot, and the shots do less damage, I will add that, but you can just spray people down from long range, or any range, because you can even do pretty good accuracy just with it, no scope. And yeah, you can spray bullets fully auto that do a ton of damage, and you have a scope. So yeah, if you have a crap load of money on your team and you feel like being scrubby, or if it's last round and you want to make sure you win or tie or whatever, you can get an auto shot of you. And it's just, it really doesn't get any better for holding off angles with this. Although, if they do get close to you, then you're probably screwed, but that's the way it is with any sniper. You're better off with this than an AWP if they get close to you, pretty much. Unless you're good at flick-shotting and no-scoping, which a beginner is probably not. Yeah, that's it. I think that's it for the guns. Yep. So now we'll move on to nades, which, like I said earlier, I do have it set to where I can buy all the nades. So, we'll just move on to some basic nade stuff. Because you can normally only have 4, and not 4 types. I mean, you could, but if you buy 2 flashes, you can only have 2 other types. You can only buy 1 of any other except for the flashbanger. Can you buy multiple decoys? I can't even remember right now. I think you can. Yeah, you can buy 1 and then buy another one. You can only have 1 at once, though, I think. I feel stupid because I don't even necessarily know that right now. But anyway, there's the incendiary grenade, the decoy, the flashbang, the high explosive, and the smoke grenade. And I'll just get all of these. And I do have it set to infinite ammo, so I can keep showing all these. So the incendiary grenade is essentially what it is called. And also, I'll just add on T side, it's the Molotov, it's not the incendiary grenade, and it's also a couple $100 cheaper, because they're not as useful on T-side. But anyway, the incendiary grenade is just a grenade that has fire. And it's great for just holding off stuff like this, like I usually would throw one near it when I'm watching B, and it holds off the push. Unless people feel like running through it and taking some damage, which a lot of people do that. Well, not a lot, but some people do it, but then they're weaker. So, doesn't really help them too much to run through it instead of just waiting. But it's good if you're trying to hold stuff off. And then you have the decoy grenade, which I will admit, it's kind of useless unless you're doing some elaborate strategy in which you throw decoys somewhere and then, like, everyone either goes there or goes away from there or something and tries to trick them. But it's just a
Decoy.
grenade that you throw it and it makes the sound of a gun and it shows on the enemy's mini-map that
Deploying decoy.
there's someone there, although it's pretty obvious that it's a decoy to most people. Then you have the smoke grenade, which is also great for holding stuff off. Because, you know, you
Laying
can
down
throw one
smoke.
in there. And then they can't see through there. So you can move up, or you can just hold it, or you can just throw it to keep them held back. So yeah, the smoke grenade is a
Laying
great
down smoke.
utility for getting out of places, even you
Throwing
can drop
smoke.
one behind you. And also, if you're going in for the cheeky ninja, you buy a smoke. You go up to where the
Smoke.
bomb is, you throw your smoke, throw
Deploying
yourself a
flashbang.
decoy, and then you hold E for the defuse. And yeah, going on to the flash, as I just demonstrated, flashes are great for clearing places out, blinding people. You just
Deploying
throw it,
flashbang.
it'll flash. If
Flashbang.
people are looking at it, it'll blind them. And even if they're not looking at it, they will most likely look away. So you at least have a second of cover. And then you have the high explosive grenade, which it's just a grenade. It's great for clearing out
Grenade
certain
out.
corners. You know, if someone's over there at van, you can just
Grenade out.
chuck a nade over there and
Throwing a grenade.
hurt them. So yeah, I mean, a grenade's just great for being a grenade, is what most people would
Throwing a
think of a
grenade.
grenade. Something that explodes. And something that's really important about grenades, and it's just a basic skill, basically, a basic knowledge for a grenade, is that left click does a full pull and
Grenade
throw.
out.
Full throw.
Grenade.
If you hold right and left click, it
Grenade
does a
out.
half throw, so that's clicking both at the same time, then releasing
Grenade
both at the
out.
same time. And if you do left click, it just drops
Grenade
it,
out.
basically. And over time, you'll learn essentially how to throw it to get to certain places. You know, if you just want
Grenade.
to get one right in there, you would do that, or you could just
Throwing a
do a
grenade.
mid-range throw. And you know, you'll learn essentially that jumping
Grenade.
makes it go higher and running makes
Grenade
it go
out.
farther. And yeah, you'll just.
Grenade out.
That's just basically it for nade throws. Just left is
Throwing
farthest.
flashbang.
Both at the same time is a
Flashbang.
mid-range throw. And right is just a
Deploying
drop.
flashbang.
So that's it for CT side and showing each nade and what it does. But I'll quickly switch to T side so I can just show you the T side exclusive weapons real quick and talk a little bit about them. I killed myself. No.
We will make them cry.
So, let me end this stupid warm-up. Now it's starting up the match. Better get my max money. Okay, so the first T-side exclusive is obviously the Glock 18.
Be safe. Let's go, my friend.
And it's your starter pistol. It's just the most basic pistol for T-side. You know, I don't really know what to even think about the Glock. I'm good with it sometimes. It has its plus sides, but honestly, the CT side pistols are better overall. But it is a good pistol if you're running in and trying to get a lot of body shots. But it's not as good as the CT side pistols for trying to pick people's heads off. And it does basically no damage. I mean, I literally had one game on Mirage where I had the bomb right here, it was planted. And I was in a connector here, and I had an op, and I'm not sure why I didn't use it. I was just like, I wasn't even thinking. So I peeked out with my Glock, and the guy was defusing, and his teammate was, like, right there, and he was kind of trying to shoot at me, but I shot this guy 8 times with a Glock, and he didn't die. And they were all hits. Like, I mean, it said it was, like, 60-something and 8. It was outrageous, and I should have been aiming for the head, but I guess I was worried about his teammate. But, yeah, it does practically no damage. But it could, I mean, it's good enough for a pistol round, and it could help you sometimes. And also the Tech 9, which this is potentially the best pistol in the game. It's certainly the best standalone pistol in the game. But you can just go in spraying with this thing, and it's also decent at picking. Not as good as the 5.7, but I mean, you don't even really need to pick. You just go around and take someone down with the Tech 9. It also used to carry 32 bullets instead of 24, but I must admit, it needed a little bit of a nerf, because it was way overpowered then, and it's still somewhat overpowered now. Yeah, it's a great gun, and it can give the T-side the edge on some rounds. Let's see. We have the Galil, which, it's a good weapon if you can't afford an AK. I kind of like it better than the Famas. It has a good rate of fire. It has a good mag capacity, and I mean, it's decent for taking people down. It's also decent for headshots. It's just a good gun. Then you have the AK, which is really the most important T-side exclusive. And it's a great gun. I don't really know if I prefer the AK over the M4A4. I definitely do in some cases, because the instant headshot ability with it, one headshot no matter what, unless it's through something. I have seen that before, although I don't know why, but if you get a headshot on someone with this, it's taking them down first shot, no matter what. If you're just straight up getting a shot on them. And it's also good for spraying, if you learn the spray pattern. And it's also cheap. It's only $2,700 compared to the M4A4, which is $3,100, or even the M4A1S, which is $3,200, which essentially gives the T-side the ability to keep up a decent buy, even if their economy is somewhat broken, which is one of the plus sides of T-side. And also, you have the gun that I pretty much hate, the SG-553. Its spray pattern's crap. It's a pretty terrible gun, but once again, for a beginner, I would highly suggest using this gun, because it has a scope, and it does good damage. It's basically an AK with way worse spray pattern and a scope. So it is a pretty good weapon if you're wanting to have a scope and want to keep up a good economy. Then you have the T-side auto sniper, the G3. And really, even though it costs the same amount, it's pretty much just a crappier version of the SCAR-20. Its accuracy is not quite as good, but it's still, if you have enough money to pull one of these out, then you should have a very good chance of taking the enemies down with this. But, yep, good old auto shotty. Good old auto sniper. And also on T-side, you obviously can't buy a kit, because why would you defuse your own bomb? And the last T-side exclusive weapon is the MAC-10. Which is where the where the MP9 would usually be, and it's a good weapon for the price. For $1,050, I mean, you can get armor and an SMG for only $1,700. And a lot of the times on Mirage, or really any map, if I get the bomb planted on the first round, and then lose the round, I'll tell my team to force up on the second round and buy an SMG and armor so we can win the second round. And the MAC-10 is great for a second round buy, because, I mean, it costs practically nothing and you can get armor with it, and then it's a good gun. It's really good in close range, obviously at medium to long range it's not too good, but if you just need something extremely cheap and want to be able to get kills, then this is a good gun. Well, I think that's about it for this video. So, this is Mr. Epic 115, and don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and keep checking back to see when I'll upload further parts of this tutorial, which is not even essentially a tutorial. It's kind of a... Well, this part's more of a tutorial, but it'll get more into a guide, essentially, on how to kind of play these maps and stuff like that, how I would play them, good spots, good strats, stuff like that, nade throws. But, yeah, I'll try to keep uploading as soon as possible, so see you next time, people.